about 85% of all fractures heal. So that really means that only 15% don't heal. So why didn't it happen? A malunion of a fracture is really a fracture that is healed in a way that causes functional deficit. One example I can give you is malrotation of the femur. When the fracture was fixed, it was fixed in a way where the leg was rotated. And it's clear when you stand that the foot is really angled. Now, there are limits to that. The body can tolerate a certain amount of rotational deformity, but if it's too much, it's going to then cause a chain reaction, if you will, of the body. A nonunion of a fracture is a fracture that hasn't healed. And the problem with a nonunion is, number one, they can be painful. Number two, they can limit your function, typically because of the pain or the instability from the fracture still moving. Usually, the problem is in one of four domains or some combination thereof. Infection, the blood supply to the bone, the biomechanics of the fracture, and then the patient's own host factors. Our approach is really to look at all four of those things and address those in a very systematic fashion.
We have very specialized techniques in reconstructive microsurgery, the ability to transfer living bone with its blood supply, osteotomies, in other words, re-breaking the bone, using thin wire external fixators, the Elizarov method. We have very, very powerful tools that are not available in other centers around the country, and they're right here at Penn Medicine in our Penn Orthoplastic Limb Salvage Center.
Not all the fractures I take care of heal. It's the reality of the kind of work that we do, but there are resources out there for providers who might see situations they don't do on a regular basis. And for those providers, the Penn Orthoplastic Limb Salvage Center is a great option. We're always available, and we're always willing to have that conversation to figure out what the next best thing is for both the patient and the provider.